few things that we left with in the storage administration, right? One is what we're discussing on the other day, thin, thick, and in thick, there are two things, thick lazy and thick eager. Okay, so these things we will discuss today. How to do that? Let's see. Mr. Vadim, how you manage the storage? Okay, there are a couple of advantages and a couple of disadvantages in terms of technical, in terms of financial. We'll discuss these things in storage management, which is thin and thick. Okay, so now tell me, I have four hard drives. I have four different hard drives of, let me take five different hard drives of 1 TB each. If I said 1 TB each, the physical capacity of the drive is 1 TB. What you will do, you will create
Learn
on top of it. Okay, I'm not talking about LAN or SAN or NAS. Okay, doesn't matter whether it is a SAN storage or it is a NAS storage or a local storage. Okay, thin and thick concept won't change. Understood? Okay, so if I create a RAID 5 with 5 hard disk, what will be the usable space? I said one TB.
Minus one. 4 TB.
This, what's going on? Okay. One, right? 1 TB each. So usable capacity will be 4 TB. Okay. So the same thing I have. ESXi host. Okay, one ESXi host. If I allocate this disk to this ESXi host, it will be get formatted into data store, right? It will be formatted in a data store format. What is the file system?
VMFS.
VMFS. Okay. Now, I have created a couple of VMs on top of it. This VM size is C drive 40 GB, D drive 1 TB, E drive 1 TB. Okay, similarly, this server, how much space that we allocated so far? how much space we allocated so far?
Open 4 KB.
Around 4.5 TB. What is the data store size?
4 TB.
What is the data store size?
4 TB. 4 TB.
Usable is 4 TB.
Size will be somewhere around 3.8 TB or something you will get. But how much you allocated? 200 and 360, right? Plus 4.36 TB. If you calculate all these numbers, you will get somewhere around 4.36 TB. But when I go back to the machine, and go to the machine, in the sense ESXi host, and go to the data store and check for free space, I can see around 60% is still free. Means out of 3.8 TB, around 1.8 or 1.9 TB is free. Used is 1.9, free is 1.9, let's say 50-50. Understood? But on the front, it is showing that 4.36 TB is allocated. How it is possible? Can you believe it or not?
Yes, I think the dynamically it is allocating space, like whatever it is needed, it is taking, and rest is thing that it is free.
In which format? In thick format or a thin format?
In thin format. Thin provision.
Format, what it will do? Yeah, you got the answer. In thin format, what it will do? Okay, listen carefully. So, in thin format, for example, I'm representing the data store like this. This is your data store. Okay, of too much calculations. Let's restrict it to 100 GB is the data store size. And I have created one Windows machine with C drive of 40 GB. So ideally, it should take away 40 GB, and free space will be 60 GB, right? Ideally, it should happen like this. Now, if you are using thin provisioning, what will happen when you create a virtual machine? Whenever you are creating a virtual machine, right click, next, next, next. You want me to show that? Okay, so create a virtual machine. Server, Windows, take any Windows flavor. Okay, when I select SSD 2, 88 GB is free. And I'll set it to thin. Next, finish. If I say next, finish, machine will be created. Machine will be created under this data store. Okay, but it will occupy only minimal space in KBs. It will not occupy 40 GB. Okay, now what I will do, once the machine is created, right click, power on, and mount the ISO. What ISO you will mount it? If it is a Windows server, you will mount the Windows ISO. If it is a Linux server, mount the Linux server, Linux ISO, right?
Yes.
Now what happens? From the ISO file, it will copy the binaries and it will try to install it on this data store. Then it will gradually occupying the space. Gradually, it will occupy the space. How much? Around, let's say, OS is taking around 16 GB. So 16 GB will be used, and rest of the 84 GB it will show it as a free, means 16% used. But when you log in into the server, once the installation is done, you log in into the server and check, you will see your C drive is 40 GB, out of which 16 GB. Your C drive is 40 GB, out of which, what is this? Okay, let me try this. Yeah. Something wrong. Okay, so 40 GB, out of which 16 GB is used, and 24 GB is free. Not 24 GB, it is exactly around 39 GB is the C drive size, and 16 GB is free, around 23 GB is free. This is what it will show you inside the machine. But on the back end on the VMware side, it will show you 82 GB is free, 16 GB is used. Okay, so similarly, I got one more requirement for one more server 2. Can I allocate 40 GB? Okay, I got one more requirement for one more Windows server. Can I allocate 40 GB? 120 GB. And actually how much used? 16 plus 16 plus 16, how much? Not even 50% used, right? 48% useless, for example. So I got one more request, 40 GB. You will allocate or you will not allocate? On the back end, it is showing us 50% is still free. Okay, are you going to allocate another 40 GB or not? Okay, you have to put some benchmarks and best practices, recommendations, and go through the portals before you allocate something. But still, blindly, I can see 50% is still free. I will allocate 40 GB. So your allocation is become 160 GB. You allocated 160 GB, but actually you are holding 100 GB, and you used another 16 GB, let's say another Windows server. How much? 62? 64? Yes. 64 GB? 64 GB is used. Okay, and you got one more requirement. Will you be able to allocate it? I'll say, boss, sorry, no. Mine is almost 64% used, and I am still with 36% free space on the data store. Actual data store, actual usage is 64 GB. Okay, but I promised customers around 160 GB. If 1, 2, 3, 4, okay, all the four customers are started putting the data, how much additional space you require? How much additional space you require as per the promise? 60. But you over provisioned. What exactly you have is 100 GB, and you over provisioned 60 GB, means 60% is it a 60%? 60% over provision. Normally people will treat 35 to 40% over provision is okay, manageable. 60% is up to you. I mean, how you want to manage the risk. Okay, what will happen if these people are started putting the data? It will keep on increasing, and all of a sudden they won't put the data, that you already know, right? Even though if one customer has put data suddenly, there is a way to manage it. I'll explain. Okay, so once it reaches 60% or a 65%, okay, you have to plan how to increase this. If I want to increase this, do I have a space in the backend? If it is a local or if it is a network, if it is a network, it is SAN or NAS, doesn't matter if it is a SAN, if it is a fiber channel or iSCSI, doesn't matter. On the backend, talk to storage guys, see if the space is available, increase by 10%. That is how you will do the storage management. Okay, whenever it reaches the 60 or 70%, increase 10%, bring it to 60. When it reaches 70, okay, how it will work, I'll explain. When it reaches 65%, you have your monitoring tools in the company. Which monitoring tools? BMC Petrol.
Smart.
Smart IT, BMC Smart IT, right? Couple of tools are there. What they will do, they will keep on monitoring the utilization on the C drive, on the D drive, on the Linux machine, on the ESXi server, on the data store, whatever the parameter that you mentioned, they will keep on monitoring it. Once you define the threshold is 70% or 65%, it will generate an alert. Okay, alert will be active for some time, and later on that will be converted into ticket in the storage queue. One ticket will be automatically generated for storage queue, and storage people will validate and expand the space according to the process you set. 10% increase it. So when they increase 10% on the back end, they will send an email to VMware team. I have increased the space on the storage LAN, so and so storage LAN. Okay, please increase the data store size. So you can expand the data store and it will become 110 and utilization will become 58%. After 1 week, again it reaches 70%. Again they will increase 10%. It will become 120 and it will keep on going. As your business grows, as your customer data grows, it will keep on growing. What will happen if all of a sudden put the data on the data store? Okay, it reaches 90%. Okay, it reached 90%. You have to understand, you are not running your business with one data store. In vCenter, you have a 64 host, okay? On the back end, SAN storage, you have 30 or 40 data stores. Agree or disagree? Yes. Okay, out of which one data store is 90% full as per this calculation. So what happened when the data store size is increasing and people are putting the data, and system VMware will automatically monitor, okay, this data store is around 80% or greater than 80% full. Let's do one thing, identify small machine, and this machine I will move into another data store without any downtime. Okay, so that the actual data store which is keep on increasing, it will free up something so that other machine can save the data. This automatic process, you call it as SV motion, storage V motion, that we will discuss later on when we are doing testing. You understood? You have multiple data stores on the back end. Okay, system will check automatically, oh, this data store is being used rapidly. Let's do one thing, let's free up some space. So it will identify, and which one is free? Okay, this one is free. Okay, let's move one or two VMs from here to here. That's it, done. Okay, you understood what I'm trying to explain?
Yes.
Okay, another thing, what is the another advantage here? Okay, so let's say you have given How many servers you have provisioned here? How many servers you provisioned? Four, right? 160 GB, four machines you provisioned. Okay, hello.
Four.
Okay, so four customers are paying monthly bill of 160 GB. 160 GB, for 160 GB, you are charging them for every month. Okay, but they haven't used 160 GB on the back end. How much they used? Around 60 GB only, around 60, 65 GB only. Okay, they are unnecessarily paying for the space which they haven't used, but still you will not supply when they demand it. So they have to keep their business in such a way. They must have a seed drive 40 GB. If they are running with 16 GB Windows server, okay, they ask for 20 GB seed drive, you will not supply. You will say, this is my standard seed drive is 40 GB minimum. So whether they have to use it or they don't want to use it, it doesn't matter. They have to pay for 40 GB only. Okay, that is different story, but simply you are getting bill for 160 GB, but you are maintaining only 100 GB boss in the back end. So 60% profit, what exactly you have and what exactly you are recovering from your customer. Understood? Or any confusion?
Got it.
You are actually keeping less amount of storage and you are projecting that I have this much of storage, please pay me. And customer is also paying. That is the beauty of thin provisioning. Okay, thin provisioning, what you have to understand, when you allocate a storage, will not pick the space from the data store. What picking the storage from data store means what? Let's say Windows server is there. Okay, I have data store. Data store format, what is the data store format? VMFS. Okay, Windows server, you allocated 40 GB. What it will do? This chunk of 40 GB, it will again format it. In which format? In which format, boss?
NTFS.
NTFS, perfect. Okay. And can you create one more Linux machine? Yes, you can create. And Linux machine is 8 GB. OS size is 8 GB. But Linux server, your build standard is 15 GB is the OS drive. Or 15 GB is OS drive. So this will again format ext5, right? Agree? So
yes.
in thin provisioning, when you allocate a storage, it will not do anything. It will simply create one pointer saying I have 40 GB of space reserved on this data store. I can grow up to 40 GB. Now I am using zero. That is what the meaning. Okay, once you start putting the data inside the Windows server, it will keep on formatting the drive or keep on formatting the data store and use it for their internal purpose like NTFS. Understood?
Yes.
Thin provisioning, but one disadvantage is if you are using high transaction servers where IO ops, input, output, IOPS, you require high IO operations. Okay, high read and write operations. This thin provisioning will give you little latency, very little latency. Because when you are putting a new data, okay, it has to format it and then write the data. It has to format it and then write the data. There is a delay in processing data writing. You understand what I'm saying?
Yes.
Okay. So whenever there is a requirement called high transaction servers like SQL, okay, SharePoint, any other applications like database applications, where there is a high IO ops requirement, please don't use thin. Please don't use thin. Use thick provisioning. Means whenever customer knows that, whenever customer knows that this is going to be a DB, critical DB server, okay, he will simply say thick provisioning. He will simply say thick provisioning. Otherwise, you can consider everything is thin provisioning in VMware. Okay, clear? Okay.
Yeah.
Then, what is thick provisioning?
It will pick the allocated space from data store and format it likewise as per the operating system. It will fix the allocated space. Like if we have allocated 40 GB to a particular server, it will fix 40 GB and format it.
If I have data store, okay, same 40 GB, if I allocate by using thick provisioning, what it will do? It will format 40 GB and keep it ready. Doesn't matter. Two things. Thick has two things. What was that? Lazy, eager. Eager means, what is the meaning of eager? Okay. Eager means rush.
Want to know something.
Okay. Eager to. Yeah. Eager means rush. So what will happen? The moment you allocate 40 GB, it will sit and format first. Sit and format first. So formatting 5 TB or 1 TB or 2 TB data store in Windows format or a Linux format will take at least 4-5 hours of time. Means when you are using thick eager, create a virtual machine, next, finish. Okay, that finish will never finish for next 6 months. Sorry, 6 hours. Means in the taskbar, I'll show you very simple thing, but in this taskbar, no, okay, creating virtual machine, it will be active for 6 hours because it is doing format in the backend. Getting what I'm saying?
Yes.
Okay, thick eager means it will format. Thick lazy, thick means it will occupy. There's no alternate. Thick means it will definitely occupy 40 GB. Directly it will minus 40 GB, but it will not format anything. It will just create a pointer and sit. This is lazy. This is eager. Okay, in between, if there is a thin, okay, it will just simply create a pointer and again it will say 40 GB, but it will not occupy any space. Thin. You getting what I'm trying to explain? Let me show you. Okay, so of my Active Directory server, right? Where it is sitting, let me see. Edit settings. Come on. Where it is sitting? It is sitting on SSD. Fine. Okay, it is sitting on SSD. Let me go back. SSD2 has refresh select and refresh a couple of times. Sometimes it will show you bug. 88.7 GB, right? How much free space? Hello.
88.7.
Okay. So I want to allocate 5 GB thin provisioning to this Active Directory machine. New hard drive with 5 GB. The size is 5 GB. Let's see. Say new hard drive, it will by default it will go to this. I'll say sorry, don't go to SSD, I'll put it on SSD 2, select here thin provisioning 5 GB, under SSD 2, 5 GB, save it. See, done, completed quickly. I have allocated thin provisioning of 5 GB. Nothing occupied. Select and refresh. Nothing occupied. But in this machine, if you go and look at edit settings, spicy boss. My bad. What happened? I haven't allocated or not? Let me see. Edit settings. No, it is not allocated. New hard drive, 5 GB, hard disk 5, okay, and I'll say thin provisioning, let's say it is N. Yeah, it created one hard drive. I don't know why it is not showing up. See, I'll show you. Data store. You see, it created one disk. It created, but somehow it is having some bug or something. It is not showing up. Let's see. Edit settings. Is there as a view is hidden, 5 GB is created, man. Okay, so if I go back to the machine, disk management, you see disk management, scroll down, you should see 5 GB unallocated disk. It is there, right? Okay, 5 GB is there. But in the storage, 88.7 GB untouched. Okay. So what happens? You can create volume. Still, you go back and refresh. See, it got something. Once formatted, 88.7 will become 88.68, around 20 MB it occupied, right? Because of the format. Now you have an edge drive. You put some data on it. How much? What is the size? 63 MB. So once I start putting the data, okay, 65 MB. Just refresh now. See? It occupied. Right? You understood? When you put the data inside the drive, then it will minus it from the backend. Till how long? Maximum 5 GB. Thin provisioning clear? Are any questions? Nice. No? Hello?
Yes.
Oh, sir.
Edit settings. Let me assign one more 5 GB. One more 5 GB. One more 5 GB. Thick, lazy. Thick, lazy. Remember. Select. Thick, lazy. I'm creating 5 GB. The moment I save. The moment I save, watch it here, the result column, okay? Directly 50% and complete. Directly 50% and complete, okay? Now go to SSD 2 and see, 88 become 83. 5 GB directly minus. Okay, 5 GB directly minus. Go back to my picture. Lazy, when I say lazy, it will directly minus the 5 GB and it will create a pointer. It will not format anything. Once it is formatting, you will see it is keep on increasing gradually. Let me do it. Let me show you. When it is formatting, now this status bar will move slowly, slowly, slowly. That is only the difference you can identify. Existing hard drive. Sorry, not the existing hard drive. New hard drive, thick, eager. Eager means format immediately. Select thick, eager. Oh my god, 5 GB. So now observe in the result column, it should start from 1%, 5%, 3%, 9%, like that. Save. See, 5%, 9%, 12%. 17, it's keep on formatting the 5 GB. 22, see? 3. What it is doing? It is keep on formatting that 5 GB what you have allocated. Now you can imagine, just for 5 GB, it is taking this much time. If it is 1 TB, you can imagine this status result will be like that at least for 2-3 hours, or at least for 2-3 hours minimum. Understand the difference between these three?
Yes.
Any questions up to this? Finally, it is formatted. Now you go back again, 75 GB, 78 GB. Initially it is 88. You allocated two thick provisioning LANs. One is lazy, one is eager. So straight away 10 GB minus. Right? This is how it works. Any questions? Small topic, but when it comes to storage management, it has. Delete the data files from storage. Save it. Guys, come on. Any questions?
No, sir.
No.
Okay, so. When I said delete, disk will be removed from here, but on the backend storage, the disk file will reside over there. It will not delete. So you have to select this option so that the backend disk file, VMDK file, will also get deleted. Okay. Save it. Now you should see around 88 point something is back. Original space, what we have. Any other questions on the topic what we discussed? Okay, we'll stop it here. The storage management, thin versus thick provisioning. Also, still have a couple of more things to do. Tomorrow we'll see this more of theory. Okay, I don't require the lab and stuff. Not even I don't require lab. Not we don't even power on the lab. It's more of theory that we will discuss tomorrow. Questions? I'll stop here.
No, I don't know.
All right, yeah, let me stop here.